guys. Just sitting down here in the shade at the beach, just near the marina where we've got the boat. It's a free marina as far as we know. We haven't seen anybody, nobody's told us to pay. So we're staying here until, I think, we might go tomorrow on Sunday and go through Chalcis Bridge. Even though it costs about, I think it's 75% more than a weekday. But we thought maybe we would get through faster and earlier if we went on a Sunday, because maybe nobody else wants to go and pay a few extra. So instead of it being 35 euros, it would be 62 euros. But the problem that we find is that the bridge doesn't open for boats to go through until 10 p.m. and it closes at 4 a.m. So what we do is we go and pay to go through, and then we go and go on anchor and keep our radios, our VHF on channel 12, and then just wait for them to call us to go through. That could be at 10 p.m. or it could be at 2 a.m. It could be any time, just I guess it depends on when they decide to open it, what the tides are like, how many cargo ships are going through, because cargo ships and things like that get preference, they get to go first, and then sailboats and smaller boats get to go through. So yeah, we just have to wait to go through, and then we have to, once through, we have to go and find somewhere to anchor on the other side. So hopefully if we go tomorrow night, it will be a bit quieter and we'll find somewhere to anchor. The other thing is that other people might be not wanting to go through, so they'll still be at anchor. But I guess we'll see. We always work it out anyway. I turn around, you see the beach. So, I don't know if I've mentioned this or not, but the beach is here. It's pretty crap, really. We haven't been wowed by any beaches in Greece, apart from the ones that you can't get to unless you've got a boat, and they're, you know, few and far between. And even then, quite a lot of the time, if the tourist boats go in there, people end up dropping rubbish and there's crap on the beach anyway. But the mainland ones and ones on the big islands are pretty much like it. There's sand, and then as you walk in, it changes into stones and rocks. Sometimes slippery, sometimes not. It's squishy. You've got to be careful of sea urchins in some places. So quite often I will actually wear my thongs into the water, just because, yeah, I'd rather prevent any injuries happening rather than just walking in and possibly standing in something that sting and hurt and possibly send me to hospital. So I think I am going to be investing in some little plastic shoes, or I'll just have to get these really, really ugly swimming shoes out and to cover them. So I guess it doesn't matter, I'm wearing them in the water, and so pretty shit shoes should be pretty good in there. It's warm today, nowhere near as hot as the other past couple of days that we've had. It's been so nice being tied up to the town quay, because it is just cool and we get sleep. It's quiet after about 11 p.m. because here, every night, doesn't matter what night it is, As soon as it gets dark, the locals come for a walk and they go all around the waterside. So they walk along the quay and along the restaurants and everything, and they just go for walks, which is really nice to see. So we just have to wait for them to stop walking past our boat before we can go to bed. So what else have we been doing? So today we went for a little walk into town. We found a Euros shop called Happy Monkey. We were the only ones in there. I think most people do their siesta because it's hot. It was nice. €3.50 for a pork Euros with everything on it. It's quite filling. It's got pork, onion, tomato, tzatziki, mustard, and fried potatoes. Really good. Really good. I try to only have like one of those, maybe I have it twice a month. I'm still not, I don't feel that great when I eat meat. I think even on the boat we've been having a little bit of ham. But I still have my vegan cheese. I know it sounds really weird that I'm having ham and I'm still having vegan cheese, but I'm pretty sure I've got a problem with dairy. I can't drink milk. You can't eat normal cheese. I've tried having some of Clay's blue cheese and it just makes me feel sick. There's the marina over there, and I think there's a boat going in just next to ours. You wouldn't have seen it. They moved it pretty quickly. They did it a lot faster than we do it. Actually, no, they're not next to us. They're next to... there are a few boats up. They did really well. And we did it yesterday because you have to reverse back. And then tie the back of the boat to the quay. So I have to grab the lines, the ropes, jump off the back of the boat onto the quay, take one rope and tie it to a ring. Take one rope and tie it to the ring, and tighten it off. And then take the other rope and tie it to another ring. And then Clay grabs the mooring rope, which is tied to another ring. And it runs all along the bottom of the water. And then there's like a skinnier rope tied to it that you pull up out of the water at the front of the boat and tie off on the cleat on the bow. Clay is not the one that's supposed to do that. I'm supposed to do that. I cannot jump from the quay back onto the boat. He does it. He shows me. It's super easy. It's not that far, even though I am sure that is more than a meter to jump. And I have to jump from, sometimes the quay is like a meter higher than the boat, and the step that I have to jump onto is small. So all I can see is me jumping on and face planting, or me going to jump and landing in the water, or me going to jump and hitting my head on the davits. So there are a lot of injuries that could possibly happen. So luckily he's very fast and get the boat in the right position, grab the rope. I've already tied off the boat so it's not going to go forward anymore, and he will keep the motor in forward so that it stays off the quay and doesn't crash into the quay. I hope all of this makes sense, but it is a full-on learning curve, all this sailing stuff. it's not easy. And I think the older you get, the more worried you are about injuries, especially if you haven't done it before. It's definitely not for everybody. I have been going through some really, really low days lately, because of the heat. We haven't been getting off the boat. There hasn't been places to go and see. We don't like to leave the boat on anchor for too long without either of us on there. And it's quite stressful to tie up at a marina. Once it's done, it's great. And I want to stay for days because you get so really good sleep. You can just get off the boat, walk around, go and have a look at things. Yeah. So now I'm a bit happier, it's better, I'm enjoying it again. So yeah, anyway, I'll talk to you later.